this is Ruby, and today we're going to be talking about Z-scores. We're going to be talking about the tail, the body, and between mean and Z. So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to look at, is our unit normal distribution, and we're going to talk about how to use that unit normal distribution, which is a Z-score table. So remember, the first thing that you do is you compute your Z-score, which is simply taking X minus mu over the standard deviation. You want to remember that X is your raw score, mu is going to be given to you, as will the standard deviation, and you'll find your z-score. All right, and once you find your z-score, look at is our z-score computation, which is just simply taking the raw score minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. Then once we get that z-score, we're going to find out whether or not it's related to the tail in the distribution, whether or not it's related to the body in the distribution, or whether or not it's related to mean and Z, is we're gonna look at the unit normal distribution. And what you'll notice is the unit normal distribution is also called the Z-score. We have a Z here, and remember that a Z is made up of simply the raw score minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. Once we have Z, we then go to our Z table, or our unit normal table. And what you'll see is in the Z column, we have different Z's listed. And you'll have Z's in your particular case listed from 0 all the way to 4. And what you see is we have B, C, and D. B is proportion in the body, C is proportion in the tail, and D is proportion between mean and Z. Now, if we look over, and I'm just gonna go ahead and move this over just a little bit and make it just a hair smaller so that we can see the whole distribution a little bit easier. Let's try to make it a little less crooked. All right, still a little crooked, but there we go. All right, so what you'll see is the body, which is our first one that we see at the upper right, which is labeled as B, that's much greater than 50% of the distribution. Keep in mind that the distribution would be everything that's under that curve. So we see that the body crosses the mean and it's greater than 50%. So for example, if we had a Z of 0.22, we'd know that the proportion in the body, we'd look in the B column, and the proportion in the body would be 0.5871. So we could easily find those proportions for the body. Now the tail is less than 50%, and the tail is identified by C. And what you see is that that area in the tail is quite a smaller area than the area that we were looking at in the body. And it's less than 50% of the distribution. So for example, if we were to look at 0.24 and we were to look at proportion in the tail, what we see is that proportion in the tail is equal to 0.4052. And you can see that overall proportion in the tail, except for at the mean, is gonna be smaller than proportion in the body. Now, the last thing that we're gonna look at, and it's here at the bottom, so I'm just gonna pull it up just a little bit, is proportion between mean and Z, which is in the D column. And you see that that is the last distribution that we see at the bottom there, and it's labeled D. And so that gives us the proportion that's between our mean of 0 and our Z value. And so let's say that you had between mean and Z, and let's say what you had for Z was 0.340. Well, what we know is that that proportion, that would be proportion from 0 to our Z of 0.34, would be 0.1331. So what your task here is that you will not only have to compute the Z, but then you will have to decide whether or not what you're looking for in the problem is a proportion in the body, a proportion in the tail, or a proportion between mean and Z. Okay, so we're going to continue on with another video, but we're going to stop here for now, and I will see you soon. Bye!